Darnell, Mohammed and Rebecca face your vote. Who goes? You decide tonight in Big Brother at 9. Talking of decisions, there are a few crucial ones about to be made right now.
£22. £250,000. Just one question. Welcome to Deal or No Deal. Welcome to the final Deal or No Deal before our summer break. Aww. And the final episode in the Bankers Summer Spectacular. These two battered suitcases have really been influential this week. One's got sunburn in it, and if the player gets to £5 and opens that, it means that the banker gets the opportunity to look in the player's box. And that produces a fascinating game. And one has got sunshine, which instantly gives you a holiday for two abroad, and the opportunity, if you so desire, to proceed opening a box and then getting an offer. And yesterday we saw it have a major impact upon the delightful Helen, because by her own admission, she had such an awful start to the game that her heart had really sunk. But she found the sunshine, she knew she'd got a holiday, wanted to give it to Mum and Dad, which was very nice, and I think it built up her confidence to take on the banker, and she went away with a very, very nice sum of money. So, last play for the battered luggage. Who's going to be the passenger?
Bing bong! This is the final call for passenger... William!
Yeah! Willie boy! Go on, William! Your big moment has come at last. Welcome to your game.
Thank you very much.
Do take a seat. Are you comfortable?
Yep.
William Henderson from Tyne and Wear. Retired.
I am.
From what?
I used to be a blacksmith in Swans, but the skill...
In the shipyard?
In the shipyard, yes. But the skill went out of the blacksmith's job, so I packed it in.
So what did the blacksmith do in shipbuilding?
Done farewell and forgings and everything. Mm. And then all that just went out the bag.
All in the interests of making more money?
More money.
Hmm. Okay. You've got some interesting dreams here. You wish you'd been a red coat.
I did. I would have loved to be in a red coat, and I was very disappointed. I should have really went for it, but I didn't.
All your mates reckon you look like Norman Wisdom.
They did.
Can you do an impression?
No.
Oh, you go. Oh. Okay, all right. If you have a big win, what would you like to do?
I'd like to buy a cottage with a hot tub.
Do you like your hot tub?
Oh, I do love the hot tubs.
Doreen likes the hot tub.
Oh, she does.
What have you brought with you here, William?
Well, that's my granddaughter's little toy, and she really loves it.
Who we got here?
This is my granddaughter, Jessica, and my grandson, James.
Lovely.
They're two lovely people.
What a superb picture, like that. What's your attitude to gambling, William?
Well, I've gambled practically all my life, but I haven't done as much lately because I didn't have the money, you know. But years ago, 1960s, we brought the bank at a casino, but it was around about £150, which was a lot of money them days, of course,
yeah,
you know.
Absolutely.
And there was six we broke the bank, and then we raced out in case the grab were... Because there's always a possibility if you take too much money out, you know, they wait outside the door for you and just... But we got away.
How's he going to play this game?
Just as he thinks about the numbers, he's got no plan.
But are you comfortable if he decides he's going to have a gamble?
Yeah, whatever's good with him's good with me.
Excellent, that's what I like. How long have you two been together?
41 years.
41 years, well done. OK, are you happy to move on?
I am.
I need you, please, to confirm that you chose box number 10 at random before the game began.
I did.
Sealed by the independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes. Lovely lady. And she's the only person who knows where the money is.
Yes.
But, William, I want you to have an absolutely fantastic game. William, Doreen, good luck.
Thank you very much. Well, the first box I'm going to, let's see now, is number 3.
Why?
It just hit us right in the face.
Yes. And the box as well. Get us underway, please, Val.
Good luck, Willie.
Thank you.
What is it about the 100,000, the quarter mil, they're taking it in turns to pop out early on in the game? No more.
No more?
No more.
All right, then. Right, number 6. Let's see what you can do, boys.
All right, Lee.
Come on, Will, please, come on, blow.
Oh.
Sorry, Will. Sorry.
All right. All right, then. Number 4.
Ah, senior stewardess with my crazy hair. Lovely girl.
I really hope this is a blue for you, sweetheart.
That's all right.
Wee darling.
Yeah! Come on! I think we'll take number 2.
You all right, Cheryl?
Yes, thanks. Good luck, Willie. I hope it's a blue.
Thank you very much.
Oh, William. William, focus. Get over to the left. 15,000's gone now.
I think we'll have number 12.
Thank you, Tim.
Willie, you are such a funny, funny man, and I hope this is going to be just what you want.
Yeah! Hello, banker.
Last show. You got your holiday book. Where are you going? Oh, you're taking some acquaintances to the Bermuda Triangle. Yes, we've got a little Willy here on the crazy chair. One opening round, Willy. A disaster. You think William and Doreen can handle it? Ah, yes. The banker's heard that you two are pretty good when you get into hot water.
Very good.
You're going to save a lot of money in this game, are you, for your holidays? Oh, William, £500.
Oh,
you're not finding him generous. He's going to have some holiday money held back, 500 quid. Mind you, that is a big hole on the right-hand side, isn't it?
It is.
£500. Are you going to go at the first offer?
No way.
No way.
No way. You asked me the question.
£500. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
Right, number 15.
I'll miss you, little man, and the smell of your aftershave. Well, I think it's your aftershave.
Five grand's out of the game.
Number 14.
Shallots and luck, hope it's a
thank you. Holly, come on! Come on! Come on!
Right, we're going to take a break now. I don't mean a summer break. It's just going to be a little break. The nation are approaching. Could you kindly persuade them to return to your game, but only if you want them to?
Well, I'd like you all to come back to my game, because there's still plenty of money in this box here. Bless you, this one here.
It's just treat it purely.
Do you follow that around?
Yeah, you treat it purely as a guide that it has these red lights on the top of it, you see.
You're right?
Yeah.
Well, I'd like to come back to the show because there's still plenty of money in there for me and I hope you're all enjoying it like I am.
Way aye.
Way aye.
Welcome back to William's Game. William retired from the North East shipyards and is a test pilot for hot tubs.
Right. I think I'll go with number 9.
Stacey Ann.
Another beautiful girl.
I think we could do with 1p, 50p or a pound, frankly.
I hope this is a blue.
What a charming and obliging young lady.
Oh, they are.
Hello. What are you planning for your holiday? Oh, you thought you might go and visit Willie and Doreen for your holiday.
Anytime.
Yeah, up in Tyne and Wear. Anytime, she said. What about jacuzzi time?
Well, we haven't got one yet.
Ah, you see, they haven't got it yet. But you could deliver it and install it. A much better round for Willie. Oh, that's going better. You had £500 to start with, and you now have an additional £3,000. £3,500 is your second offer. That's better.
Can I have the question, please?
£3,500. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you, Willie.
Number 8.
Ray. Why do you always look like that, Ray? Are you
worried? So worried.
What are you worried about?
Worried for William that it might not be what he wants.
Oh, I didn't worry. I'll deal.
All the best. Good luck, William.
Thank you for caring, Ray.
Yeah!
That's what he wants.
Number five.
Bez.
It's a good choice.
Yeah.
Here we go, Will.
Thousand, that'll do.
Well done, Bez.
Come on.
I think I'll take the other. Number 16.
Okay. Best of luck, Billy.
What do you think now?
Absolutely great.
Yeah?
Yep. Couldn't be better.
You're only here for a laugh. You don't want the money, do you?
Nope.
No, I do.
Of course I do.
He's just here for a laugh.
I don't want it, but I need it. There's a difference.
Yes, an improved round for Willie there. Yeah. Ooh, he says Willie keeps rising. It's 7,500. Ooh!
I'm ready for the question.
£7,500. Deal or no deal?
Thank you very much, but no deal.
Thank you. Right, we've had a good laugh. It feels like end of term time, doesn't it? Everything getting a little bit silly, but...
Getting a bit serious.
The fact of the matter is, wouldn't it be fantastic to complete complete the third season of Deal or No Deal with our first male quarter millionaire. And you could still do it, Will.
Number 18.
Wendy, there are 6 blues. And we would love a 1p for Willie. $10,000.
Not bad.
Not bad?
Not bad.
Okay.
Could do with a few blues, but not bad.
Well,
not bad, but I could do with a few blues. Come on. Roll the name! Roll the
name! It's an interesting configuration.
Very interesting.
But you've got to get 2 blues now. You want 4 all at 8 bucks.
Number 20.
20. Come on, Jace.
Good luck, Will. Be nice to meet you, man.
Thank you.
Yeah! Right, now you need another blue.
Well done, mate. Well done. Well done. Well done. Number 17.
Lisa. Box 17. Gets us to 8 box. Need this to be another blue, so it's 4 all.
I really hope this is a blue, because I'd hate to see you with a red willy.
Lisa.
Snow.
Would you kindly open box 17? Oh, my word. 20,000.
Oh, yeah? Come on! Come on! Yeah. Come on. Still got that big one! Still got that big one!
Willie, you have the mighty money.
I am.
You've got a fantastic backup, 50 and 35.
That's good.
It's good, but it's dangerous, Willie.
Now,
yeah, I think it's dangerous. And the next offer, which will come right after the return of everybody, is going to decide whether or not you've had enough or whether you are going to try and go for one of those suitcases. And one of them could change your game and the other could really give the advantage to the bank. It's the last stage of our summer extravaganza. Don't miss it. This could be fascinating, and this guy could be hugely wealthy. Even though it's summer in the Dream Factory, you still have 2 weeks in which to nominate somebody you feel deserves the opportunity to take the walk of wealth. Do you know somebody who could be a Deal or No Deal Christmas star this year? It could be a close friend. Maybe a member of your family, somebody from your community. We're looking for exceptional individuals who have truly inspirational stories. For details on how to apply, the terms and conditions, go to channel4.com/deal. And remember, we must have your nomination by August the 8th. We're at 8 box, and this, I believe, is going to be one of the more interesting offers we've had for some time. It is precarious. Oh, 20,000 changed the complexion of the game when that said goodbye. 9.5 grand. It's still climbing, but it's 9.5. It wasn't a big leap.
What do you think? Numbers in there.
Yeah, I think so as well, mate. Put that smile on your face and carry on.
I'm enjoying it.
Too much.
I want to win that toilet 50 grand in the
Go on, then. Go and get it, Willie. Go and get it. You'll get those 3 blues next round.
I want to get to them boxes when I can't open one at a time. Great.
Well, you've made your mind up there, mate.
And win the holiday.
Come on, Willie.
Come on.
Come on, Willie. Yeah, I have the cup.
rest of you know. May indeed, William. A pleasure to deliver it to you, sir. £9,500. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you, William. Right. Okay, regardless of what happens in the next three boxes, we're on our way to the battered suitcases for the last time.
Number 11.
Nikki, we've got five blues, and for once, we've got no reds that we want to get rid of. We have to hold on to those three if he is going to make the most of his opportunity to find the sunshine and then get that offer after each box. Nikki, first of the blues, please.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah! Okay.
Right. Number 7.
Wouldn't it be absolutely fantastic if the final deal or no deal for season 3 ends with you winning £250,000? It would be perfect. Absolutely perfect. But there's 35 and 50,000 we also want to hold on to. Mike, 1p, £5, £50, £500. One of those, please.
Yes! Yes! Oh, wow.
Wow. Wow. Find another blue.
22.
Okay, Barrow. Can he do an all blue round at the perfect moment and set us up for the most fantastic suitcase selection?
William, you're a ray of sunshine.
Thank you.
I hope it's a blue. I really do.
Oh, no. Well, we're denied, you're denied. Everyone's denied.
Come on, come on.
Third game in a row that the 35 and 50,000 have sat there at this point. You've got to find the right case. If you get the sunburn, he has a look in that box. But if you can find sunshine in one or two, get a guaranteed holiday for you and Doreen somewhere abroad, and you get the chance, if you wish, after you hear the offer, to go on and play the game box at a time. Which is it to be, William, one or two?
Number 1.
Willie. We've had two of each. Hopefully this one is really in your favour and a lot of sunshine is about to come into your life. Ah, let's find out where the holiday destination was. That's the sunshine. Oh, Willie. The tickets were 2 to Jamaica. Oh. A Caribbean holiday would have been yours if you had said number 2.
Come on, Willie. Come on, Willie. Oh, right.
Come on.
Come on. Come your leg.
William, the banker and the independent adjudicator are now going to look inside your box. Now, he had one great victory against Adam, where he found out there was 50,000 in the box and he got Adam at 10, which was pretty good going. But M played a brilliant game. And even though I think the banker convinced everybody that the quarter mil was sitting there on the table, M didn't believe it. She read his mind and she went away with £28,000 despite the fact she only had 10p. So, William, this is not all over just because he's having a look. But you are going to have to think about the monetary value of the offers very, very carefully. You will get the swap at the end. So if he starts just offering low, you know you can swap your box at the end. Jivers is returning. Your box will have a fresh seal, the banker's seal on it, signifying that the great man has actually had a peek inside. So the phone will ring and he will make you an offer, William. And you may decide the mind games are a little too much. You may decide you've had enough of the game and you want to get out of it. Hello. He says, thank you very much indeed for choosing that suitcase. That's made his day. Yes, we're waiting for the offer, banker. It's £4,000 and one penny. Greeted with silence as people actually start to digest that information. Remember, he knows what's in box 10. That's interesting, sticking a penny on the end when you've got a penny in the game. Has he seen a penny in box 10?
Good offer, really. Good offer. There's a long way to go. We've got that 35,000 and that 50,000 there. So...
Willie? We've seen it all week, bluffs and double bluffs. Six of one and half a dozen of the other, as you know. Everyone's thinking he's offered you low because you've got the penny in your box, but none of us have Scooby-Doo, do we?
William, I'm really, really sorry, but be careful and take something home for that lovely wife of yours.
I've got to think about it yet.
Willie, play it as though he hasn't looked in your box, mate. That's the only way you can do it.
Oh,
get rid of the mind games.
Yeah.
Still a lot of money out there.
£4,000 a lot of money.
Don't go in with that penny, mate.
That penny, mate.
Have a chat with Mrs. Willie.
Have a chat with Mrs.
Willie. Have a chat with Mrs. Willie.
What do you think, boss?
It's your game, Will.
I'm ready for the question.
William, £4,000 and one penny. Deal or no deal?
Deal.
For a hard-working man.
Thank you.
Okay. That was terrific what you said there. Never had that sort of money in your life, so we all fully embrace the reason why you decided. Time to stop. Now, of course, you know just as well as the rest of us, William, we now have to blow the game apart. I'd love to finish season 3 with a memorable victory. A really nice guy.
Thank you.
Find 35,000 and 50,000, please.
Number 18.
Ruby, welcome to the game. Could you please reveal 50,000 or £35,000? No. Right. If you decided to go on, we would have been cheering. That would have been very nice. And once again, we'd have been trying to work out what did the banker see. Why did he offer you £4,000 and 1p? Got to find them in the next two.
21.
Stuart, do it for us. 35 or 50.
Stuart. Fingers crossed, hopefully I can do it for you, William. Do a big red.
No, the 1p. So when the banker looked in the box, he did not see that you were on your way to the 1p club. Did he know that you had one of the massive sums of money in the box but decided to pitch it that low? Ooh, has he really caught you out big time? Find 50,000.
Number one.
Emma, we want to see 50,000. If this is £50, it is a massive disaster. Go on, Em.
Hope it's a red.
This is £50. He was destined to have at least 35,000.
Oh. Yeah!
It's not going to be enough. But William, the reality is that ain't gonna be enough.
Oh, I'll do that.
Oh my word. He's done it again. William, you said 4,001p was more money than you'd ever had in your life and you were happy to take it. William, you've got the banker's gamble. You give him the money back, he'll let you go on and possibly win £35,000. Okay, William, you can have either box. You get the swap with this. Come on, Doreen, come and share this moment. This really is a tremendous climax. Welcome. I think we need your help at this point.
I know what I'd like to do. You know me. But I've got to think of them too. And ourselves.
Would you keep it or swap it?
I'd keep it. Yeah.
You definitely keep it, why?
He always said he wouldn't swap his box.
Okay, that's fair enough.
We'll never swap it.
The banker knows the contents of box number 10.
Yep.
So why did he offer £4,000 and one penny if he saw 50 quid?
Whatever you think, I'll go along.
Well, I've already made my decision.
Good. Okay, then. Right. Fine.
You ready for the question?
Please.
William. Banker's gamble. Deal or no deal?
No deal. You're happy with that, aren't you?
I am, honestly.
Right. Well, you said you wouldn't have swapped, so this is the true climax of your game. And has he been incredibly clever? Has he been typically evil? Have you actually beaten him? That would be a great way to end our third season. But I saw how difficult that was for the two of you. Is the reality that you really, really could have changed your lives for your family? William, Doreen, were you destined to go away from here back to Tynan Weir with £35,000? Could you please open box 13, Brian?
With pleasure.
£35,000 was there. You said you weren't the swap, so it's never going to be yours. Hey. I think he's probably ringing up. No, not to congratulate. He's going to ring up and say, thank you for ruining my holiday. Hello. Thank you for ruining my holiday, William. Really? He's had a real twinge of conscience, William. Yeah, you made him more evil than he felt comfortable with. Trying to persuade you to go on and go with the £50. William? William? You're going to the Caribbean, William. Tickets to Jamaica, you're going on holiday, and you have £4,000 and a penny. Well done, William. Brilliant. And that is season 3 of Deal or No Deal. We're now going to take a summer break. We will be back on Monday, August the 25th, the bank holiday. Monday, August the 25th. I hope you have a summer that is absolutely perfect.
I need someone who really cares.
myself. I won't do that again. It's got to be.
And something else that's perfect is Come Dine With Me on Monday at 4:30. Next, Poor Judy's still feeling unwell, so it's Richard and Emma Bunton with the three celebrity MasterChefs.